not be on.
Yeah, I don't know if it's obvious on television. We have monitors here, and it doesn't look as obvious on TV as live here. But Daniel Gill's size advantage is pronounced. I know Miguel Cotto's obviously the stockier guy, but Gill's a much bigger guy, it looks like here.
It does, but Miguel Cotto also hurt Daniel Gill with that last body shot he hit him with. You watch it, you saw that arm snatch back really, really quickly. Shows you that he has that respect on him.
There's a left hook to the head by Cotto. Perfect short, tight shot inside that landed and also seemed to bother Daniel Gill.
But Cotto made his presence known with the very first punch of the fight, that left hook to the body. And he's also boxed pretty well here.
Miguel Cotto from landing left hooks. He will not have a chance to win the fight.
No, but he just landed a pretty good left hook of his own.
Thank you. saw Cotto land another left hook to the body. So the money punch is back in a very big way for Miguel Cotto, as it was against Sergio Martinez, as it was against Delvin Rodriguez. That was obviously priority one for Brady Roach, to put the left hook into the arsenal. Heel touches the canvas with a glove, and referee Harvey Dock rules it not a knockdown.
So far, what we're seeing is two different classes of fighter. Gil's a good fighter, always been a good fighter. But Cotto is of a certain class of fighter where he's been able, as Roy said, not only to carry his punch up, but success up with him from 140 to 47 to 54 to the middleweight division.
Well, if you're looking for Gil's deficiency coming in, it's difficult to define other than that there's no X factor. There's just no weapon for Daniel Gil, which can change a fight the way Cotto can change it with his left hook.
Well, his size may change it, Jim. You got to be careful here because he's doing a good job of moving around. Now he's avoiding the left hook better. He's big enough to absorb some of this punishment and last for a little while. He's naturally a very tough character. So if Cotto does not go ahead and discourage him and lets him get into this fight, we could see a change here.
How should Gil move to try to blunt Cotto's left hook?
He has to move to the right to stay away, to the left to stay away from it, to avoid it. Right then he moved to the right and ran right into it.